So in today's video, I have 6 quick Illustrator workflow tips that you might not know. Now I've selected 6 workflow functions within Adobe Illustrator that are lesser known by most designers, and so you can add them to your library of Illustrator processes to fit right into your workflow. Sponsoring today's video is Milanote, the best place to plan and streamline your next graphic design project. Milanote allows you to generate ideas and concepts with ease, and then to evolve those creations to final design solutions. As you probably know, I use Milanote myself for my design projects, and you can learn more about their awesome project planning software later in today's video, and just how helpful Milanote can be for your creative design process. We can pull guides from the rulers like so, and that's something fairly basic that we all probably know about. However, in Illustrator, we can literally turn any vector path into a guide, and it's very easy to do. So let me demonstrate by taking the polygon tool and then creating a triangle. All you need to do is to come up to View, Guides, and then Make Guides. I can then rotate them, cut them, and edit the guides as I see fit. So another good use for this tip is that you can make a set of lines like so with the pen tool, and then use the Alt Option key to duplicate one line, and then press Command or Control D to repeat the process. So any guide that you make would allow you to snap a point to it, you know, snap a shape or a path, and this just works the same as any other guide in Illustrator. So like before, we just need to come up to View, Guides, and then Make Guides. It's that easy. So the second workflow tip is a quick one relating to the Shift key. Now with text highlighted, we can head into the character window here or press Command or Control T. We can increase the type size right here. But if you want to speed up things a little bit, just hold down Shift when you're increasing or decreasing the text itself. Now this is a good little time saver, but it works for so many other functions in Illustrator. One example being the adjustment of tracking here. So try this tip by holding down Shift on various different processes in Illustrator, because it can be used in many different instances. So the third tip for a better workflow is again based around the Shift key, but being used in an entirely different way. So when you open up the color window, you can pick a color from the spectrum bar right here. Notice that it says RGB spectrum. But if you hold down Shift, you can click and change the color of the mode of this spectrum picker. So you might want to use CMYK, HSB, grayscale, or you know, whatever you want. You can simply toggle through these color modes by holding down the Shift key and just clicking on the spectrum bar. Tip number 4 is something again really quick, but it's really useful to know. So when you have the Eyedropper tool in use, the shortcut being I on your keyboard, you can click a shape, so for example this circle here, and then if you hold down the Alt Option key, you will notice the Eyedropper icon changes. Now this means if you go ahead and click a different shape, you are going to transfer the same fill and stroke attributes of the original shape into the new one. So the 5th of 6 different workflow tips today is a very simple function, and many of you probably know this one already, but if you want to see your design in all its glory without the panels and things obstructing your view, simply press the Tab key and all of the panels would temporarily be hidden. So pressing the Tab key again will bring them back into view. However, if you do know your keyboard shortcuts very, very well, you can still work like this to some extent. So for example, A being for the direct selection tool, and this will allow me to edit the circle in this way that you can see here. But yeah, I often hit the Tab key just to have a quick look at my design with nothing obstructing the view. So the last tip today is again relating to views, and I've got a basic design here to demonstrate, but I can actually save myself time by setting up specific viewpoints. Now if you come into the View drop-down menu here, you will notice at the bottom it says Add a New View. So first make sure you're viewing your design in the way you want to, so maybe zoomed into a specific part, and then save the view and give it a name. If you're working on a large or a busy design, it might be a good idea to set up views in many different ways to zoom into different parts of the design very easily. Now you can also save a view to see your entire design, or maybe even zoomed into one specific anchor point. But yeah, big thanks to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. I really do highly recommend it, and I've been using it for nearly 2 years now myself. You can easily streamline your creative process from start to finish on any project that you're working on, but also it's very easy to share your ideas and your projects with other clients or even work colleagues. So yeah, do check out the links down below for more information on Milanote and start streamlining your creative design process in a more efficient way today.
Make sure you have a great day, everyone, and of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.